The name of lesson is Gopal and the Hilsa Fish. So, actually, comic is a book in which stories are shown or stories are told to you in the form of these kinds of pictures, as you can see on the screen. So many of you have read it, so I'm sure everybody knows about that. So let's read it how it is. We read over here that it was the season for Hilsa fish, a kind of fish. Fishermen could think of nothing but Hilsa fish. You know that whenever there is season of something, like if that is season of a particular fruit like apple, then whenever you go in vegetable market to buy something, then everywhere you will see apples all around. If it is orange season, then you will see orange all around. Then in the same way, the season was of Hilsa fish, and everybody in the town, in the village, which is mentioned over there in our story, everybody would have been talking about Hilsa fish only. Fishmongers sold nothing but Hilsa fish. Only one kind of fish was sold by, fish seller person, selling persons in this season was Hilsa fish only. Come, buy. The price of Hilsa is down today. And you know very well, whenever the thing is in abundance, means when it's in you can see a whole quantity of it in the market, then obviously the price of that thing goes down. So if you want to buy a fruit when it's on not in the season, then you will have to give a big price for that, a lot of money for that. But when it is the season, then the same things become cheap, that things you can buy in less money. So come, the price of Hilsa is down today. Householders could talk of nothing but Hilsa fish. How much did you say for that, Hilsa? Even vendors who go home to home, they were also selling Hilsa fish only. How much did you say for that, Hilsa? You wouldn't believe if I told you. Means it's quite cheap. If I'll say that I'm selling it on this particular price, you won't believe. It's quite cheap. And in the palace too, courtiers could discuss nothing but Hilsa fish. In the court of the king, only one thing was discussed, and that was again Hilsa fish. Your Majesty, you should have seen the huge Hilsa I bought, caught. It was, means people used to boast of this thing, that the Hilsa fish which I caught was so big, you could have seen it. So you can say that the whole town was talking about only Hilsa fish. Now what happened? Stop it. Even king was annoyed with that. King was bored of such kind of talks. Are you a courtier or a fisherman? Now he gets angry whenever he sees that people in his court were talking about Hilsa fish only. That are you a courtier? Means are you a minister in my court, or are you a fisherman who sells the fish? So are you here to sell your fish, or are you my courtier? So won't you talk about something sensible? The courtier fell silent with downcast eyes, means eyes lower down. The king felt guilty. Now the king was nice. King was kind-hearted, so he felt bad when he realized that he had scolded his courtier. I'm sorry, I lost my temper. It is the season for Hilsa fish, and no one means king is also fed up of all these talks. He's saying that everybody in the town is talking about Hilsa fish only. Don't you have anything other to talk about? Not even Gopal can stop anyone from talking about Hilsa fish, not even for 5 minutes. Now, Gopal must be a kind of funny person for entertainment, or can be a courtier in King's Court. Now, you must have heard about the stories like Tenali Rama and other Akbar Birbal. where king keeps a person who is quite witty, wise, and who you know, who is quite close to the king. So in the same way, Gopal is also like same person. So king says that even Gopal, a wise person like Gopal, cannot stop whole town from talking about Hilsa fish just for 5 minutes. Just distract whole town and let them talk about something else, but not about Hilsa fish. But Gopal said, oh, I think I could, Your Majesty. Gopal says that I can do this. Then king says, then let me see. You buy a huge Hilsa and bring it to the palace without anyone asking you a word about it. Now, what challenge is given by king to the, you know, Gopal? What kind of challenge he gave? He gave him the challenge that, this is a challenge for you, that go to market, buy a big Hilsa fish, take it with you, come to my palace, and I want that nobody talks to you about Hilsa fish. Means that person can talk about anything, but not about that fish. Then I accept the challenge, Your Majesty. Now Gopal accepts the challenge. And what does he do? A few days later, why is your face half shaven? Now what did Gopal do? He grew the beard and mustache. He didn't shave for many days. Now one day when his beard and mustache was fully grown, what did he do? He shaved his face half. Now his wife asked him that, why have you done this? I'm dressing up to buy a fish. Now he said that I am getting ready to buy a fish. What's the matter with you? Why are you smearing? Smearing means covering your face. Why are you smearing yourself with ash? Ash, you know very well, when the fire is burnt, coal is gone, then ashes are left. So why are you smearing yourself with ash? I told you I am dressing up to buy a Hilsa fish. I told you I am getting ready for buying Hilsa fish. Now what happened? Listen to me, please. You can't go possibly go out in those disgraceful rags. Now, what did he do? He also wore rags, means torn clothes, old clothes, worn out clothes. And he started going outside the home and his wife stopped him. She said, you can't go outside in these rags. What are you up to? Means, what do you want to do? How many times must I tell you, woman, I am out to buy a huge Hilsa fish. It's happened to him. He has gone mad. Now the wife is thinking that her husband has gone mad. That why he's behaving like this. Why he has dressed up himself like this. Then, when he went out, Gopal bought the Hilsa fish and started walking towards the palace. Now see, as you can see in the picture, he bought a Hilsa fish for himself and then he started walking towards the palace. Now the people started talking about him. Mother, look at the man. Isn't he comical? Means, doesn't he look comic? He must be a madman. Hush. I think he is a mystic. Means a person who behaves like a joker and tries to make other people laugh when he makes fun of somebody or when he cracks jokes. Now see what happens. When Gopal reached the court, what do you want? Now the guards who were standing outside the palace, they asked, what do you want? I want to see the king, Gopal said. You can't see the king get away with you. Means, see, how are you looking? You can't meet the king. Gopal began to dance and sing loudly. Now, Gopal didn't go back. He started dancing. He started singing. Then what happened? Inside the palace, now the voice of Gopal could be listened inside. Now, when the king heard it, the people were talking about that man, Gopal. The man is crazy. Throw him out at once. I want to see the king. Let me in. This is the request made by Gopal. Bring that man to me at once. Now he ordered the one of the guards. And then he said, yes, Majesty, I'll bring him inside. Gopal was brought before the king. It's Gopal. Now Gopal was brought in front of the king. The man has lost his mind. Now the courtiers were talking. I think it's one of his crazy jokes. Now courtiers in the court know that he is Gopal. Now they are talking about that, you know, like he has gone mad. He thinks that it is also a joke to come like this in the court. Now what happened? All right, Gopal, out with it. Now you are done with it. Why are you dressed up in this ridiculous fashion? Ridiculous means hilarious, funny. Why are you dressed up in this funny fashion? Your Majesty, you seem to have forgotten something. Gopal said, I think, Your Majesty, you have forgotten something. Forgotten something? Strangely enough, no one seemed to be interested in Hilsa fish today. Now Gopal declared that, see, Your Majesty, no one in the town is talking about Hilsa fish. They are talking about me. From the market to the palace and to in the court, not a single soul, means not a single person, has spoken a word about Hilsa fish. Nobody is talking about Hilsa fish. Whole town is talking about me only. Only then did the king remember the challenge he had thrown to Gopal. Now king remembered the challenge which he had given to Gopal, and he said, ha ha, well Gopal, congratulations. You have achieved the impossible once again. Now see what you have done. You have done something which was impossible for anybody else.